I built this using AI. This is actually a landing page builder, a website page builder. I'm not talking about the center of this region, but actually the whole thing. This is a page builder that I built using AI in just 4 hours. Okay, I'm just going to refresh this page. So this is how the page looks. So I can go in here to the layout components. I'm going to drag it. There's the nav bar. Then there's a hero section. I'm going to add a feature grid. I'll add a testimonial and a pricing section. Come down and I'm going to add a CTA. Okay. And AI helped me build something like this. I'm going to click on this image, go to the styles. I will actually click on this overlay color. I'm going to change the color to something like this. Okay, so the color is changed. And you can see that this particular input color that you see is not the regular HTML color. This is actually picker. So the difference between the default HTML input color and this one is that this has RGBA compared to that one having just RGB. I can, you know, increase the height or whatever. Come here, I can maybe select this one and let's change the background color to something like this. So I can come in here, click and drag to increase the padding. And let's select this one. I'm going to change the title to something like this. All right, so we can customize it however you want. And of course, this is not the final product. This is just something that I got to very, very quickly. And the tool that I used is this one, Tempo Labs. Trust me, this is the best tool I've used so far to code using AI. And if you just look at the landing page itself, you'll realize that it is not just one of those tools which will let you code using AI, but it is also a design tool. So if you just look at the landing page, you can actually click and drag and move these things around. You know, you can just move these things just like that. So probably that is an indication that this is also a design tool. So I'm going to do one thing. I'm just going to click on login. Okay. So I'm logged into Tempo Labs, and if I go to the left side here, you can see that I've been building a few things with this application actually. I built a script writer. I tried to build an auto zoom screen recorder. That is not complete. I tried it 2 times. And this was the third thing that I tried, which is the landing page builder. So if I just double click on this, I can open that project here. And you can see if I just scroll, there is so much of prompts that I've given. There are times when it'll go in the wrong direction. What you have to do is you can just go back and say, this is going in the wrong direction. So let's go and restore it to a stable version. So I've done that few times when it was going wrong. I've spent about a day and a half using this tool and I've learned a lot of stuff. How the prompt should be, how it should not be, because I tried various different methods. I tried simple prompts. I tried very, very detailed prompt with technical stuff in it. And what I've realized is that for the first prompt, the best thing is to give it a simple prompt and it will give you a starting point and then you can add the technical aspects later on. Okay, so this is the start of the project. So basically I said, build me a landing page. This is how I started this one. For the other projects, what I did was I gave it technical details right in the starting. And with regards to this tool, what happens is that it will give you the design first and only then the functions will be added. So you might think like, okay, it looks like a full app, but it's not, it's just the design. It's not working properly. So you have to ask for the functions in the second prompt. Okay. So what it does, it actually does a lot of things that are different from every other tool. Okay. Right at the first prompt, you'll get a PRD, which is this one. Okay. So if I just expand this, you can understand. So there is a Mermaid diagram, which will explain what you're building. So start, open landing page builder, view empty canvas. So you have user action, drag component, select components from sidebar. So you know exactly what you're building. And that is one thing that this tool does that none of the other tool does. So basically you will know what you're building when you look at this Mermaid diagram. Okay, not just that. So there is this tab here, there's a PRD, then there is design. Okay, design will show you the difference. So this is the main page and different components of that page. Okay, so I'm just going to zoom in. Okay, so this is how the design will be. So, and like I said, just like something like Figma, you can just use these things and select certain parts of this thing. And if you want to design it differently, you can do that. So let's say I'm going to select this. I'm going to control click on this one. So you can see on the right side here, you have all these things that you can change. I'm not going to change anything here because I already have set it up as I want it. This video is mostly going to be a walkthrough of the features that this particular tool has, and maybe I'll show you a little bit of how to get started. And in the next video, which I will do because I'm so impressed with this product, I will create more stuff with this. So what I've been doing is basically trying to create something that might help me if there is some kind of subscription that I'm paying $20 per month for something. I've tried to recreate those things. So I guess even if I'm not selling something, I'll at least reduce my subscription costs. If you really want to go in and make changes to specific changes to the design, you don't have to rely on the AI and waste your tokens. And you can see here that I don't know if it is tokens or credits, whatever they call it. I have 40 million for this month and I have already used 15.9. And now you have to understand that I've tried to build at least 5 applications to, and in the process of 1.5 days, I kind of just went crazy using this app. So I did kind of overuse it, but it was also a learning process wherein I realized that to start with, just give a straightforward, simple prompt. It will give you the plan. And if something needs to be changed, then you can prompt back and say, I need this thing changed. That is a better approach than giving it full detail about technical details and stuff like that. Let's move on to the next tab here. And that is the code tab. Okay. And this looks more or less like any other IDE. And you have the codes here, you have the terminal here and stuff like that. And this is the AI section where you give it the prompt and the coding will happen here. Okay. So let's look at these things. On the left side, we have this dome tree. Okay, you have these things. Then you have the assets. So whatever is being used for the designs, you can have it. You can drag and drop it here as well. So this is actually very, very helpful that no other tool actually has. Then let's look at the file selector. You can see here, so the files for the code, it's available here. And then we have Git settings. So if you want to connect it to a repository, you can do that. And we have the history of all the edits that you have done with AI. So that you have here. Then for backend, you can connect it to Supabase, connect Supabase, and you can also connect it to Figma. So we've used AI to build these things. You can see it here, the design and all that. But how do we see the full page in action? So for that, we'll go to the right side here. So this play button, if you just click on that play button, it will load up the page that you've been building. Okay, so this is how this application works. I have to say, this is probably one of those products which you will not regret paying for. Okay, so let's just go back to this one. I'm going to create a new project. Okay, and come here, I'll just say generate new app. Go to next. Build an Instagram clone interface. Let's click on that. Let's see what it will come up with. I'm going to click generate. All right, you can see that it is writing up stuff and you can see the mermaid diagram is being generated. Okay, so you can see the design process. Okay, I'm not touching anything. This whole thing is happening on its own, right? On the left side, you can see wireframe, creating routes, generating header, generating Postgres, generating home route, all of those things. And it will just do all of those things. Okay, so you can see here, this is the main page. And in that, this is one section, which is the header, which is here. All right. And then we have, this Postgres, which is a separate one. All right. So let's have a look. I'm going to click on play here and that will load up this website. So this is how it looks. All right. All right. So we have the logo here. There is a home button. There is a search. This is for DM, I guess. All right, so this is the process. And in this video, I just wanted to give you an intro to the product. And in the future videos, which I'll do a lot of because I'm truly excited about this one, we will go in depth into creating something really solid with this app. And let's see what all of us can come up with. That's it for this video. If you'd like to see more videos like this, or if you'd like to see more videos on Tempo Labs, leave a comment. Please like this video, share it with your friends, and I'll see you in the next one.